Guten Abend, das ist Jacob. The first physical thing that we'll be touching via Final Fantasy 15 is this.
Boom. Look at that. Look at that box. Or, not box, sorry. Look at that cover. I think that's King Glive. Right there. It's gonna be kind of blurry. There we go. And then we got Noctis right there. Beautiful. And they're talking on the couch. The cover of April Final Fantasy 15. We didn't think it was gonna happen, but it did. So it's the back and very nice fancy painting and a dog. Doggy! So, here we go. We're going to see what the Game Informer is like. So here we go. Game Informer, Final Fantasy 15. Okay? I think this was in the first of the last cover, probably second. So as you see, we got screenshots, Bravely Second, and coupons. Ooh. I could actually maybe do that. Okay. When does it expire? 4:29. Okay. Cool. I might do that. I think. I don't know if it's a coupon though. Oh, this is saying perks you get. I was just saying, I don't think Game Informer. Okay, that. Never mind. In feeling. Okay. So we have the king, and I don't know who that is. You got some of the table of contents right there, and then we have more table of contents right there. You got Paragon. I am Setsuna. Square Enix's new RPG. That's a 16-bit. We got feedback. Okay, and questions and stuff. Advertisements. Isn't advertisements great? I love them. Oh, drawings. Okay, check it out. Oh, that's a good one. I like that. We got Yuna. Is that Yuna? Yeah, Yuna, Riku, and I think her name starts with an A. I don't remember her name though. And then that looks like Undertale. And then that one is just an anime couple, I guess. That's a really good drawing, but that doesn't have anything to do with video games. Not that it's bad, but I'm used to seeing that, you know? What is that? Oh, nothing. Okay. Number four is obviously Splatterhouse. That's really cool. I like the art style. Zooming back out. Virtual reality stuff. Talking about virtual reality, about the PSVR. Launch games. Cool. HTC 5. Fuck that thing. You know why? Because they supposedly have a Portal exclusive, which is fucking bullshit. Anyways, so Oculus Rift, HTC Vive. Don't really care about them. Yeah, so, but nothing for PSVR yet. But here's some of the games. Adrift, Bullet Train. Adrift is from 310. Bullet Train is going to be an Epic Games game. Chronos from Gunfire Games. The Climb, Crytek. Elite Dangerous, Frontier Developments. Eve Valkyrie. Huh. That'll be interesting. That is from CCP. Keep Talking and Nobody Explodes. All right. So, could be interesting. Project Cars. Oh, okay. Res Infinite. That'll be a cool VR one. And Time Machine from Minority. And then indie games from GDC 2016. A Beacon from Monothetic. It's Xbox One exclusive and then PC. Church of Darkness. Paranoid Productions for PS4 and Xbox One and PC. Element from Flightless, and it is for Xbox One exclusive and PC. And Deliver Us the Moon, Xbox One exclusive and PC. Els Noir, only PC. Frozen Synapse, only PC. Streets of Rogue for PC and consoles to be announced. Tear Through from Bandit Minus One, PC. Kitty Powers Love Life, PC and iOS. Wow. Perception, Xbox One and PC from Deep End Games. Oh, sandwiches. The thing about Aaron for Conan, which I miss seeing him on The Clueless Gamer. It's, I don't know. They just went downhill since he left, I think. Street Fighter V, some little, I guess, interview, it looks like. Modern Marvels. Marvel makes the push to bring more leading ladies to games. Yeah. So the iOS, no one cares about that. Bring it to consoles, and I'll give it a try. Top 10 Final Fantasy villains. So you can read that. And then The Good, The Bad, The Ugly. Batman, Telltale Games, The Bad, Lionhead Studios, and The Ugly, Uncharted 4. Yeah, the thing about Assassin's Creed 4. Here, let's try this. Another interview. On the edge of our seats, rounding out the best video game chairs. Well, I have a leather couch, so I think that's the best, and it's a recliner, so yay. Timeline. Oh, the release is for May. Doom the 13th. Mirror's Edge the 24th. I thought it was the 26th. People tell me weird stuff. Sherlock Holmes, Devil's Daughter, the 27th. And then the movies, of course. Here it is. Boom. How beautiful is that? Look at that. Look at that. Ah. Gonna zoom into this beauty. Look at that. Wonderful. Here's another one. Final Fantasy 15 begins with a carefree road trip, but circumstances take a turn for the worse, as we can see. What about PC? Tells you what's going to happen with PC. Right there. Okay, here's some more screenshots. Noctis fighting. The Niflheim Empire has an army of mechanical warriors called Magitek soldiers. Cool. There's another screenshot. Unlike the Duske region, Leyde is a desolate and sparse. Is desolate and sparse. Okay, creating monsters. A thing, an article about the monsters of Final Fantasy XV. And a car. This is the original concept art for the Regalia, though its design has evolved since. Oh, here's another one. Let's zoom in. Beautiful. Who is the villain? You can read that in this month's Game Informer. More pictures. Cars aren't the group's only mode of transportation. It looks like a train of sorts. Hmm. There's Noctis leaving a diner. The settings early in the game are realistic, but they become more fantastical as you progress. Oh, okay. Interesting. Very interesting. Meeting the cast. We got Noctis, Gladalus, Ignis, Prompto, Luna, Regis, Idolus, and Arden, this guy. And he got some more. Ooh, that's a good picture right there. Look at that. Nice. Battles are action oriented, but they don't require a prohibitive amount of precision. Okay. Your party travels to many different cities and runs into all sorts of denizens. Mmm, look at that. Mmm. Players control Noctis exclusively, though they direct the actions of party members in other ways. Okay. You can rest, eat meals, and pick up monster hunts at various stops along the way. Look at that. Pretty. And now, the expanding Final Fantasy universe. And the anime. Gotta watch that. Most places you visit have parking accommodations for the Regalia. Cool. I like that. Look at that. That's really pretty. You got really nice looking resort beach type of area. Trees coming from the water, mountain sides in the background. It's very pretty. Very nice scenery. That's really pretty too. Look at that. And then we got what looks like a base right here. Calling for help. A long article about that. And fishing is Noctis' special skill, but his friends have their own hidden talents. This is Blizzards in action, the upgraded version of your basic ice spell. Whoa, look at that. If we look close, you can see how foggy and murky, not murky, foggy and, you know, cloudy, I guess you could say it is. It's just very hard to see, you know. So that's pretty cool. Going platinum, this talks about the demo, I believe. So there's that. Now, oh my goodness, this is a long article. Another one. By crouching, you may be able to escape detention long enough to set up a better attack position. Final Fantasy's future. That long thing. More screenshots. another screenshot. The Regalia has all kinds of extra features like party storage, auto drive, and a radio. Well, awesome. And I don't know, that's not Luna, but I don't know who that is. I'm curious. An article about the Banner Saga 2. Don't really care too much for that, but unlike the first Banner Saga, the sequel will be coming to consoles. The new faces of Banner Saga 2, Roek, Durdrew, and Bok. Oh shit, I have 15 already, man. Wow, okay. So there's some screenshots for that. Here we go, previews, Uncharted 4. Amazing screenshots. Alerting an enemy doesn't mean your stealth run has failed. It's possible to hide and try again without a game over. Cool. That's good. Good to know. Good to know. And then No Man's Sky. So fucking stoked for this game. And then Paragon. Yeah. And Odin Sphere. Left Thrisser. I don't really know how to pronounce that one. Necropolis. Well, that looks interesting. New armor helps to better protect you from the Necropolis's many dangers. I am Setsuna for PS4 and PC. Overland and Dangerous Golf, which is going to be from ex-developers of Burnout, supposedly. That comes out in June. Okay. Tyranny. A PC game, which is an RPG. Minecraft for the Oculus Rift. That's interesting. Look at that. The first time you'll see a game in a Game Informer that mentions... Come on. Show it, you fuck. There. That'll show a VR device. So that's interesting. Hands of Fate 2. Right there. And then Crowfall, another PC game. Might be alright. And then we got the reviews. Dark Souls 3, 9.25. Division, 8. Quantum Break, 8.5. Hitman Episode 1, 6. UFC 2, 8.5. Adrift, 8. And Stardew Valley, 8.75. Then we have some other ones. Hyrule Warriors Legends, 6. Fire Emblem Fates Revelation, 8. Pokken Tournament, 7. Clash Royale, 8. And Dirt Rally, 8.5. And Classics article that talks about the Fire Emblem history. Some screenshots. And how well do you know Final Fantasy quiz? Yay! And an ad for Star Fox Zero. Can't wait to see if it looks that good. So, anyways, that is the Final Fantasy 15 article. Look at that beautiful cover. Fantastic. Look at the detail in it. Look at the detail. A picture. Maybe of Noctis when he was younger. So that is the Final Fantasy 15. We get to get our hands on it September 30th. Yes. Is that right? I believe that's right. Let me double check. Oh, got 45 seconds. Uh-oh. See if I can catch it. See if I can catch it. Oh. Yep, fucker. Yes. Okay. So, that is, again, the cover. September 30th, we can find out just how amazing this game is. And was it really worth the wait? Of course it was. It's gonna have a long-ass story. Can't wait!